हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द फोर्थ एंड लास्ट एपिसोड ऑफ अ पोर्ट्रेट ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज। इन टुडेज एपिसोड वी आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ अ स्केच लाइक नेक, हैंड्स, फिंगर्स एंड द क्लॉथ। सो ग्रैब योर टूल्स एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। नाउ फर्स्ट यूजिंग अ 2B पेंसिल शेड अ बेस लेयर and blend it using cotton. Now adding some darker shade using 10B pencil and blending it as well. It's very easy and simple process. Just observe your reference image and shade according to that. The link for the reference and the grid reference image of 1cm and 2cm is available in the description box. You can download it from there. To make this particular portrait, we have used all basic art supplies like Artline graphite pencils, Camblin charcoal pencils, normal erasers and some mechanical pencils. We haven't used any professional tools for this. Shading realistic smooth skin texture is just how perfectly you control your pressure and shade. So if you want to learn about smooth shading, pressure control, and also if you want to learn about light, then you must watch my shading tutorial video for beginner. In that particular video, I have taught you all these three aspects properly and in a detailed manner. So you can watch that video as well. Link for the same is available in the description. For blending, I am using cotton. I just make the size of cotton ball according to my section. For bigger areas, I take bigger cotton and for smaller areas, I take smaller one. Always take a new cotton when blending the base layer, because if you take a used cotton, then it may leave some black spots on your sketch that will spoil your sketch. Now I am shading fingers. For blending small portions, I always use a blending stump. Observe your reference photograph carefully and you can use different techniques to shade different parts. If you want to learn about shading techniques, then you can watch my shading techniques video. In that particular video, I have shown 6 shading techniques which can be used in making realistic portraits. So if you want to watch that video, link is available in the description box. Now using a fine tip eraser, I'm adding some highlights. Highlights are a very important part in drawing realistic. Observe the reference image carefully and shade according to that. Observation is the key in drawing any sketch or portrait realistic. It generally increases with patience. Now I am drawing the remaining hairs. I have explained the whole process of shading hairs in the previous episode, so I fast forwarded the video for this part, and if you wish to watch the previous videos, link will be available in the description, you can watch it from there. There is nothing much to explain further, you can just simply watch how I shaded the whole sketch. You might also complete your portraits after watching this video, so post them on your Instagram profile and tag me out there at VKArtPoint. I will reshare them on my personal Instagram profile, so make sure to do that. If you have any queries regarding commission artworks, then you can DM me on Instagram or just comment down below. I will answer at both the places. इट टुक मी अराउंड 12 टू 13 आवर्स टू मेक दिस पोर्ट्रेट. द साइज ऑफ द पोर्ट्रेट इज 38 by 28 centimeters. So after completing the sketch, make sure to erase the grid lines and add some final details. After adding the final details, don't forget to add your signature on the sketch. That's very important. So that's all for our portrait tutorial series. Don't forget to mention me in your Instagram post. Subscribe to the channel for more such videos and don't forget to press that bell icon to get notified each time I upload a video. I would see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.